Hello, welcome to the parts store. Yo, what up, man? Yo, where's your Octane booster? I got a big raise tonight.
Octane booster?
Yeah, dude with a Gen Coupe and talking mad shit about my Z all week, gonna put him to sleep tonight.
I mean, yeah, sure, dude, but you know Octane booster isn't gonna like make your car faster, right?
Yeah, just like my hotter plugs and colored spark plug wires will make it faster either. Where's this shit at?
Aisle three.
Hell yeah, man, dude's not gonna know what hit him.
All right, man, here you go. Good luck, I guess.
Thanks, bro, I'll catch you later.
Kids, man, I tell you.
Oh. I forgot to ask if it was two-wheel drive or four-wheel drive.
That may or may have not been an actual encounter that I had with someone back in the day when I was working at a retail parts store that should not be named. You really get to meet a lot of interesting individuals in that line of work, don't you? Either way, it's just one of those things that seems to get lost in translation somewhere, and that is octane ratings. Very similar to how some may just think that adding E85 into their gas tank will automatically make the car crazy fast, increase the horsepower. We see the same confusion with regular old octane ratings as well. Does a higher octane rating make more horsepower? Does it make your car faster? Well, luckily enough for you, that's exactly what we're talking about on today's episode of Myth or Fact. Real quick, before we get into today's video, if you haven't heard, we're in the middle of a giveaway with Konig wheels. You can win yourself a set of free wheels. All you gotta do, hop on over to fitmentindustries.com, snag some of the apparel, including this long sleeve shirt right here that we've dropped specifically for this giveaway. Every $5 spent on that stuff is an entry in to win. You know, we make a donation at the end of the giveaway, and that stuff is going fast. You're not gonna wanna miss out. Also, not gonna wanna miss out on the chance to get as low as 0% financing for 12 months through a firm on wheels, tires, and suspension. You know, time is running out. There's only a few days left to get that offer, so make sure you check it out. First things first here, we need to get a little understanding of what the octane rating of gasoline actually means. For some reason, there's an understanding out there that the octane rating of gasoline indicates, like, you know, its potency, or that it's a stronger gasoline, like it's more powerful. And that's just really not the case at all. To keep a long story short, the octane rating of gasoline is going to indicate how much compression a fuel can handle or withstand before it ignites. Now, this is a very important thing to keep in mind when working with cars that have a high compression ratio or are boosted or tuned. Because what I mean when I say igniting, it isn't when, you know, we're talking about when the air-fuel mixture gets injected in and it gets hit with the spark from the spark plug. I mean the other one, the bad one, pre-igniting or pre-ignition. Pre-ignition is when fuel ignites before it's supposed to during the piston stroke cycle. This can cause a lot of not so good things, because what happens when pre-ignition occurs is the piston will try to compress already hot and expanded gases. Plus you're having that mixture ignite before it's supposed to, ultimately causing a total engine failure if not caught like instantly. When you pull up to a pump at your favorite gas station, you're usually met with like three or so options, ranging from your typical 87, 89, 91 octane, and then sometimes if you're lucky, you can get the 93 octane instead of the 91. But for whatever reason, our brains as car guys are just like programmed to be like,
oh, higher number, more expensive, this means better, means faster.
But that's not all. We gotta stop doing that. It's really tough to do, I know. As we now all know, the octane rating is going to determine how much pressure that fuel can withstand before igniting. I want you to say that with me. The octane rating is going to determine how much pressure that fuel can withstand before igniting. And we now know that this helps prevent against things like pre-ignition. But why, you know, is this a thing? Why is it something we have to worry about? Why are there different octane ratings, and how does it help me with performance? So here we go. All right, let's go. When it comes down to modifying your vehicle, more specifically engine performance, getting more horsepower, all of that, you're going to be introducing things like more fuel and more air into your engine. At the same time, you're more likely going to be introducing more compressed air as well, especially if your car is boosted. When we talk about turning up the amount of boost, you are compressing that air more, the air that you are introducing into that air-fuel mixture. So you can probably see where this is going here, right? Or at least I hope so. As we do this, it's going to require a higher octane gasoline to be able to do this safely without risking blowing up your engine from pre-ignition. In a sense, the octane rating of your gasoline is going to almost play as a supporting mod for the rest of your performance modifications, allowing you to achieve that power more safely. Actually, one of the key reasons as to why E85 ethanol gasoline is so popular in the aftermarket world. If you didn't know, E85 has a very high octane rating, right around 108 or so. But gels, this makes sense for boosted platforms, but you know, what about us naturally aspirated guys? Like how can that help us? And that is a fantastic question. The glory of modern performance cars is that they can be tuned relatively easily, naturally aspirated included. Then there are a ton of off-the-shelf tune options readily available for a lot of those cars. When you load up an aftermarket tune to your naturally aspirated car, it is remapping the air-to-fuel ratio as well as your timing. By having your car tuned to a specific octane, you can achieve a more aggressive tune. When all said and done here, when we break it down to simplistic terms, simply pumping higher octane gasoline into your car will not make it faster. However, having supporting mods and more importantly, a tune that is the key thing, a tune that is dedicated to a higher octane gasoline will allow you to achieve higher horsepower numbers safely without having to worry about things like knock and the risk of pre-ignition. So hopefully this helped better understand the octane ratings of gasoline and what you can expect and cannot expect when choosing a different type of gas. We'd love to know your thoughts down in the comment section below. And of course, let us know what you would like us to cover on the next episode of Myth or Fact. Don't forget to check out the giveaway with Konig Wheels going on right now. And of course, wheel side suspension, FitmentIndustries.com. I'm Gels from Fitment Industries. We'll see you later.